I mean, essentially, I have never done anything with the organization before. They asked if I was interested. I said, I'm happy to, because what I knew about it, it seems like a great thing to do. It's one of those things where once I agreed to do it, and once it kind of got into the bloodstream, I kept hearing more and more about it, learning more and more about it. And my wife, actually, who's like, doesn't care about almost anything I do professionally, was actually impressed that I was doing something for this organization, which has done so much good, and it's obviously something that hits close to home as a journalist, and hoping that the next generation is well-trained and well-intentioned.
Joe Callahan, I'm the executive director of A26DC. We are a nonprofit that was founded about 4 years ago now here in D.C. We work with students ages 6 to 18 to help them develop their creative and expository writing skills. And we work with teachers to inspire their students to write. We believe that great leaps in learning can happen with one-on-one attention, and that strong writing skills are really, fundamental to future success. Our goal is to, help kids learn the power of their voice through the written word and empower them to tell their stories, and that when given the opportunity to tell those stories, they'll work hard to edit and rewrite and find the best possible way to make their stories come to life. And when they do that, we work with them to kind of professionalize the process. We publish their work in professionally bound and designed books to make them feel truly invested in the work they're doing.
First of all, I mean, I'm a huge evangelist for writing in general and journalism in general. I think it's an amazingly great profession, and I've been very blessed and very lucky, but I feel like to be able to love going to work and love doing what you do, no matter how hard it is and how frustrating it can be at times and how scary it can be at times, is a great blessing. The other thing is, I guess what I would encourage people to do is not to be overly seduced by the fact that you can do a lot of work at your desk now. It's still very important to get out of the house, out of the apartment, talk to people, meet people, engage the world, because, again, it's never been easier to get a blog or be a Twitter person and really never really leave and never really engage with the world as fully as maybe you should or would you appreciate. So I hope people would understand that writing and journalism is a full engagement game rather than a desktop game or a fingertop game.
I think it's probably endemic. People are just writing less than they used to, in the sense that they're not writing in formal ways. So for us, in a time where people are texting and tweeting and writing emails all the time, it's to know that every word you write in whatever medium has a goal and a purpose and can have power. Whether you're writing 140 characters or 140 million characters, those words have meaning. And so for us, it's investing the time and energy into helping students develop the skills and the understanding behind harnessing that power. So we work with over 70 DC public schools in various ways. So we'll partner with teachers directly to bring in students into our center. We'll work with teachers closely to find ways we can come into the classroom and support them. So it's very much boots on the ground, grassroots way of finding students who might need our help. So the event tonight is we're really, really lucky to be able to partner with Jake Tapper and Mark Leibovich to talk about kind of their experience writing and becoming journalists in DC and what the written word means to them. And for us, it's we want to be able to promote the written word in any way possible, both at higher levels and lower levels. And so for us, this event is a fundraiser, so it will hopefully help us raise some money, but because all of our programs are offered totally free of charge to our students, which last year we served 3,251. And so events like this help us keep going and keep doing what we have to do. We get some money from the DC government through the DC Commission of Arts and Humanities and through the Mayor's Office on Latino Affairs through some of their grant-making programs. We're part of a national network that was founded in about 11 years ago in San Francisco by the author Dave Eggers and the educator Nineveh Caligari. and we're now part of a network that is in 8 different cities across the country. And you know, we serve more than 3,000 students here in the district, but across the country we serve just over 35,000 students. And we do that through harnessing the power of community volunteers. Here we have a very small staff of 3 people, and we serve 3,000 kids because 1,200 members of the community give more than 35,000 hours of their time to help impact a student's life.
I don't think there's any one blueprint for it. I mean, I think there are some basic rules. Be nice to people, be pleasant, be polite, be ambitious. But also, you know, remember what's important, which is, you know, the people you love, and choose your friends carefully, because Washington, probably more than any city I've ever lived in, and probably most cities in the country, is a place where a lot of false friendships can take hold, and people, you know, can become much more transactional than maybe you want them to be. So, you know, choose who you